Well, we have some news updates on the first hopping tests of the Starhopper and an Elon Musk's update for the Starship, which should have taken place on the 20th of June.
Then Falcon Heavy prepares for its third launch ever. A launch which, according to Elon, will be its most difficult ever. And what's so special about this mission? Well, it's flown for the US Air Force.
And then Jim Bridenstine gives us some updates on the 2024 Artemis moon mission costs and how much money NASA will additionally need to make the moon mission happen in 2024 as planned. These news and more on this week's episode of Space News.
Unfortunately, we have some bad news regarding the first hopping test of our beloved Starhopper. The test vehicle, which will test the Starship's in-atmosphere vertical takeoff and landing capabilities. In a recent tweet, Elon stated, in response to someone asking when we would see the promised presentation on Starship, Starhopper flight first, waiting on engine repair. So this means that we will see the Starship presentation not before July, after the first successful hopping test has happened. Now, what's with the engine repair?
Well, currently the final engine, which is said to power the Starhopper, the Raptor SN5, underwent some testing prior to being installed into the Starhopper. It seems that it suffered some minor damage, which has to be repaired prior to being installed into the Starhopper. And not long afterwards, the hopping tests will probably begin. And Elon Musk's presentation on Starship will follow very soon after that. We also assume that the Starship website that already has been teased will launch very soon after the presentation of Elon Musk, with maybe some new updates on the Starship design and some new renderings. And hopefully lots of juicy and interesting infos about the capabilities of Starship and the plan to get to Mars and how to establish the Mars colony.
Then Falcon Heavy, the most powerful rocket currently operated on this planet, is preparing for its third launch ever. The first was Starman, an epic launch which we will never forget. The second launch was for the Arabsat, not quite so epic, but very successful at deploying the Arabsat satellite perfectly into its orbit. And now the third time. The launch will take place on the 24th of June earliest, so we of course might see some postponing. Now, what is so interesting about this mission? Well, this mission is carried out for no other than the US Air Force.
Wait, is this Trump's Space Force finally kicking off on their first mission? Sending a super well-trained team of Astro Navy SEALs to space for a secret infiltration mission to a now defunct Soviet-era space satellite that has been drifting in space with a secret payload, rumored to be a secret device invented by Nikola Tesla himself. A secret super weapon so powerful that it could hold the key for the dominance of the US in space for the next decades? No. Instead, the payload consists of 25 small satellites. Now, 6 satellites will form the Cosmic 2 constellation, which will do some measurements of Earth's atmosphere. Then the payload will also consist of quite a number of CubeSat satellites, which are small cube-shaped satellites initially developed by Stanford. Despite their small size, they can carry a few science instruments and promise a cheap way to carry science instruments into orbit. The most interesting of all the instruments, however, is Lightsail 2. This is a small Lightsail test satellite, which in folded state is only 10 by 10 by 30 centimeters small, but then suddenly unfolds into a quite respectable 32 square meters solar sail.
The goal will be to demonstrate solar sailing, that is, using the radiation pressure of light emitted from the sun to be propelled through space. In the future, this technology will play a pivotal role for the first interstellar missions to other star systems, like the Breakthrough Starshot project, which aims to send an unmanned probe using exactly this light cell technology to the Alpha Centauri system before the end of the century. These are the humble beginnings for our interstellar future. And then we get some updates on the Artemis mission. Jim Bridenstine recently told CNN Business in an interview some interesting numbers on that the mission will cost $20 to $30 billion. For everyone now crying out how expensive that is, keep in mind that the Apollo missions costed about $150 billion US dollars in today's money. And the Vietnam War, by the way, a bit over $1 trillion. And that was absolutely for nothing. So $20 to $30 billion seems actually not too much. This is because this time, contrary to the Apollo missions, the Artemis mission will be carried out, involving lots and lots of industry partners. NASA will choose from a wide array of industry partners to build the Lunar Gateway, to build a lunar lander, and maybe also to provide a launch vehicle, should the SLS not make it in time.
Bridenstine already requested $1.6 billion additionally for the 2020 budget, but in order to make it until 2024, he estimated that NASA would need another $4 to $6 billion annually on top of the annual $20 billion. Sure, NASA could just slash other projects and invest more into the Artemis program. But Bridenstine reassured that he doesn't want to sacrifice other science projects like unmanned space probes or climate change observation satellites. And he said that he's quite confident that Congress might actually even approve this request for these additional funds. If not, however, then NASA must save money in order to make the Artemis mission happen. And think of some other cost-saving alternatives, for example, going back to Falcon Heavy again instead of using the SLS. Because as we said already in another video, the Falcon Heavy costs $90 million per launch as opposed to $500 million per launch for the SLS. Look, NASA, there you can save some money. Oh yeah, and the Falcon Heavy has another advantage. It already exists and has already flown to space. But with NASA's back and forth, anything seems possible, honestly. We'll certainly keep an eye on these developments and let you know if anything noteworthy should happen.
Also noteworthy is the news that for the Artemis mission, the first woman will land on the moon, as recently stated by NASA. This is quite fitting if you think that Artemis is the twin sister of Apollo, right? Of the 12 people that ever walked on the moon, not surprisingly, all were men. So we need to get more woke now. So in this day and age, the time has come for the first woman to set foot upon the surface of the moon, hopefully in 2024, if NASA will manage to get its budget.
So what do you think? Will NASA get the additional $4 to $6 billion funding from Congress? And do you really think that the first woman will set foot onto the surface of the moon by 2024? You? And when will we finally see the Starhopper doing the hopping tests?
And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell, because we will continue following the third Falcon Heavy launch and the first hopping test ever. See you next time! Share the video with your friend! Thank you.